Hello, this is Steven from Hyfindr. I'm here today at Gilbarco, Veeder-Root and Engie Energy Systems taking a look at a dispenser. So this is what we see here, and Danny is here to explain what this is and how this works and what their new system is all about. Danny.
Great, yeah, thanks Steven. So this is our hydrogen dispenser that we produce in Janesville, Wisconsin. It is capable of doing H70 and H35 refills. We can do both high flow as well as standard flow filling as well. And it does have the option for either a single hose or two hoses. So you can fill from both sides of the dispenser mm-hmm. or from the same side of the dispenser. It is modular, so if you are in a fleet situation and you don't need the payment system, it would come with just the electronics up top so you can see the transaction amount. And then if in a retail situation and you want to sell the fuel, we have options for what we call a CRIND, or a card reader in dispenser, to be able to do the transaction.
So how does this work? This connects directly to the vehicle here, and then you pop it in.
That's correct.
Into the vehicle connection, and then this takes you through the steps, right?
That's correct, yeah.
So, and this is, so what are the 1, 2, 3 steps the driver would go through?
Sure. Okay. Sure, so to start the transaction, if it's a retail transaction, mm-hmm. they would actually use their payment card to start the transaction.
To start that, okay.
And then they would connect the hose to the vehicle.
Yeah.
And then there's communications here on the nozzle.
Yeah, infrared.
So that the dispenser can tell when it's connected, and it also collects information from the vehicle.
Okay.
You don't have to have the communications to do a transaction, but you get a much higher state of charge when you have that communications.
That's infrared based.
Infrared based,
exactly,
yes.
Yeah. So this, and then this knows how full the tank is and gets it all going, and when it's full, it stops.
That's right.
Can you say how much you want, or it always fills it up?
It always fills it up.
Always fills it up.
You do have the start stop. So if you want to stop the transaction earlier, you can stop.
Okay, cool. Perfect. Thank you. I know there's a lot going on behind this as well. And Dev's over to show us that part.
Yeah,
so
great.
Let's take a walk over. I'll take a walk over to Dev, who's right here. Hi, Dev.
Hi, Steven. How are you?
Yeah, good. Thanks.
Good.
Well, I know you're the man for behind the fence, as they say. So can you take us through what is going on here, please?
Of course. Yes, Steven. Thank you. And to complement our industry-leading dispenser technology, there's a lot of work that goes on behind the fence to make sure our customers can fuel safely, efficiently, and quickly.
Mm-hmm.
In order to do that, we provide an entire HRS system, so a hydrogen refueling station.
Yes.
We do not provide the source of gas. So as long as gas is available at the site via trailer, or on-site delivery, or on-site generation, we can then take that gas and compress it via our compression system.
Yeah.
We store it, we manage the gas, we chill it, we do site control via our site HMI, and then
HMI would be?
HMI, it's a human-machine interface, but
human
essentially
machine.
It's a site controller,
a station controller. Okay, control system.
And then what that ensures is that we apply the right refueling strategy to go to our dispensers to fill the vehicles. And as you can see in the model here, we're showing a car and a truck. You know, for the last 20 years, fueling has been focused on light-duty fueling.
Yeah.
But we're seeing the transition over to heavy-duty quite a bit.
Yeah, okay.
So we need to make sure that our station can adequately handle both light and heavy-duty.
And heavy. Okay. So So this is the dispenser that we saw across over by Danny?
Yes, yes.
So this is all piped on the floor?
Underground. No, underground, yeah.
Yeah. And then... Can you just take us through where that comes from? That goes to the compressor or to there?
Of course. So the way the gas would normally flow is if you have a trailer that comes in,
this one,
then we would use an unload panel.
Okay.
So that unload panel would direct the flow of gas from the trailer to our compound.
The trailer stays there as
yes.
As,
and there's two ways to do it. You can either unload the trailer fully into local storage.
Yeah. This is the local storage.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Or you can allow the trailer to stay to act as low bank storage, which can help reduce some costs.
All right.
So then once the gas has gone through the unload panel, it goes into our gas management panel.
Okay.
So we're showing
this
you right
here.
This
is the gas management panel. Okay.
Now, the gas management panel, although it looks very small, it's the heart of the station.
All right.
What it does is it actually manages the flow of gas to different locations.
All right.
So it essentially, all gas goes back through this panel and then out to the right location.
Okay, that's where the valves are and all the cascading.
Exactly.
And it's done in this block here.
Exactly, okay. And it's controlled by our site controller.
Okay, all right.
So then after the unload panel that goes through the gas management panel, it goes into compression.
Yes.
And then from compression, we would either go to storage or go directly to dispensing. Yeah. It just varies on the refueling strategy. There's different ways to do it.
Yes.
For us, it all depends on the application. How much gas you have to start with, yes, and how much gas and how quickly that gas has to leave the dispenser.
All right, okay. So this is essentially all the piping comes back to here, sort of?
Yeah.
So it's, and then this directs everything.
Exactly.
You mentioned that there's a way to cut cost when storing locally. Can you say that part
sure.
again?
Sure. If you do have a hydrogen trailer delivery,
yes,
if you have the ability to keep the trailer on site,
yes,
we can utilize that as low bank storage.
Yes.
What that means is that you can keep quite a large amount of gas there as your low bank storage, yeah, and then we can utilize a mid bank and high bank to yeah. complement that.
Right.
If that trailer cannot stay on site and we have to deplete it, yeah, we would likely have additional low bank storage.
Low bank meaning lower pressure or?
Lower priority.
Lower priority.
Yeah, lower
okay.
priority, exactly.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
And essentially, you know, the chiller is also very important.
This part.
Exactly. Yeah. So as you fuel hydrogen, the temperature in the tank rises.
Yes. Yeah. So we have a video about that, the whole hydrogen
exactly,
flow. Yeah.
Perfect.
But yeah.
yeah. Mm-hmm. So we have heat exchangers inside the dispenser.
Yes.
And we utilize the chilling fluid to cool down the gas as it passes through the heat exchanger.
And so it's the cooling fluid is cooled here, and the heat exchanger is
inside
there.
The dispenser.
So in that where by Danny, what we saw at the bottom there.
Exactly, exactly.
Okay. Yeah. Last one. So I know you guys are putting all the systems together. Is there anything particular where you say Gilbarco, Veeder-Root, you know, you guys are particularly making this part stand out?
Yeah, I mean, for us, our history in retail fueling through Gilbarco and our history of compressed gas fueling through Angie,
yes,
for us, uptime is most important.
Okay.
It's very important that our stations stay operational, our
yeah.
users have access to gas.
Yes.
And what we've done in creating this HRS and dispensing system is we allowed us to have real-time management, real-time monitoring. We build in redundancy, not only physical redundancy, but design redundancy as well. And that allows to ensure that if things were to occur, we have some backup in
some
place.
Some backup in place.
In
okay.
order to allow fuel to
doesn't that take the cost up of the station?
It can. But you have to balance that, how much uptime do you want versus having zero working station.
Yeah, yeah,
right?
Okay, no, so, we don't want that.
Yeah, but I mean, it's not always 100% redundancy either. You know,
yeah.
we can do a lower percentage redundancy and then increase that percentage via design considerations.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Well, Dev, thank you so much
of
for
course, yes.
taking us really quickly through the system, understanding
course.
A hydrogen refueling station, HRS, as
yes.
you call. Thank you very much for taking the time and providing a model for us.
Of course.
I wish you well as
thank
you
so
spread
much.
This around the world.
Yes, we're very excited.
Thank you very much for watching. All the best.